made up of neurons. So you can see here, this is the picture of neuron. Okay. So, and this we call it as the structural and functional unit of the nervous system. You can see actually our house is made up of bricks. So each one and every brick will make the entire house. Likewise, every neuron will make the entire brain or entire spinal cord or the whole nervous system. That's why we call it as the structural and functional unit of the nervous system. We'll get into the topic. So what is the functions of the nervous system is, actually it mainly coordinates. So coordination means, so each and every system will work together. Digestive system will work together with the cardiovascular system. Cardiovascular system will work together with the respiratory system. So everything will be coordinated by the nervous system finally. And the control. So if the nervous system was not working, our body was totally, it was not like we are on off mode. So we will be only on the on mode when the nervous system is working. So we receive the information through sensory input. Sensory input means we have the special sensory receptors on our body, like sensory receptors for vision, sensory receptors for hearing, taste, smell, touch, even in the touch also, temperature, pressure, pain, everything. And also our brain will make the decisions and our body react according to the decisions. Coming to the organs of nervous system, we have the three important organs. One is brain, other one is spinal cord and nerves. Brain and spinal cord will come under the central nervous system and the nerves will come under the peripheral nervous system. So in this picture, you can able to see brain and spinal cord will come under the central nervous system. Remaining the entire thing will come under the peripheral nervous system. So coming to the combining forms, what and all the medical terminology that will comes into our mind when it comes to the nervous system. Cephalo, which means head. Cerebello, which means cerebellum, which is the smaller brain. We also call it as the little brain. Cerebro means cerebrum. Encephalo. Encephalo means, cephalo means head. Encephalo means inside the head, which means brain. And glio. Glio means glue or any sticking material. Medullo means medulla. So medulla is also a part of the brain. Meningeo means meninges. So just remind, in our body, each and every delicate organ will have a coverings. Because without coverings, our organs will get damaged easily. In order to protect the organs, our organs are so far covered with the membranes. So the brain and spinal cord are covered by meninges. Meningeo is also meninges. Myelo is spinal cord. For example, if the word is myelitis, inflammation of spinal cord. Neuro means nerve. Faso means speech. Polio means gray matter. So poliomyelitis, inflammation of gray matter of the spinal cord. Okay. Ponto is pons. The meaning of pons is bridge. So it was a part in the brain. I'll show you in the coming slides. Radiculo. Radiculo means nerve root. Thalamo is thalamus. This is also a part of brain. Theco. Theco means sheaths or meninges. Ventriculo means ventricles. So if you cut the brain, inside the brain, you can able to see the spaces inside the brain. So that spaces inside the brain, we call it as ventricles. Ventricles. Coming to the suffixes, algesia means pain or sensitivity. Like analgesia means pain or sensitivity. And aesthesia means feeling or sensation. Paresis means weakness. Fascia means speech. Plegia means paralysis. Taxia means muscle coordination. So coming to the anatomy and physiology part, as we discussed already, so the main nervous system will coordinate all the body activities and it receives the sensory information through sensory receptors from externally and also from internally of the body. And it uses the information to adjust the activity of muscles and glands to match the needs of our body. And also the nervous system is so far divided into two parts. One is central nervous system and other one is peripheral nervous system. Central nervous system is brain and spinal cord. Remaining all the nerves and everything will comes under the peripheral nervous system. If the nerves coming from the brain, we call it as cranial nerves. If the nerves coming from the spinal cord, we call it as spinal nerves. And the entire nervous tissue is composed of neurons and neuroglial cells. So neurons are the electrically excitable cells. Neuroglial cells are the supporting cells of the neurons, and those are non-electrically exciting cells. And the neurons, we call it as the basic structural and functional unit of the nervous system. And one more important thing, the neuron is the longest cell in the entire body. So neurons are the longest cells. Neurons have three parts. I'll show you in the picture. So this was the picture of the typical neuron. So this part, this tree-like branches, we call it as dendrites. This actually will receive the information. And this part, we call it as cell body, perikaryon, or cyton. All these three words will be used for this part. And the center part is the nucleus. And here only we call the major information, everything will be concentrated. And next, coming to the here, this part we call it as axon. So from here, the axon will start. So that this entire thing, we call it as axon only. So this covering, we call it as myelin. If this covering is present, then we call it as myelinated neurons. Not for all the neurons you will have the covering. Some neurons will not have the covering. So if this covering is there, then we call it as myelinated neurons. If this covering is not there, then we call it as unmyelinated or non-myelinated neurons. And this part, we call it as nodes of Ranvier. And this is the axon terminals actually. So from here only the information will go to other neuron next to that. So likewise, the neurons are arranged one after the other. Here again, one more neuron will start. The information will jump from this neuron to the other neuron, from this nerve terminal to other dendrites, other neuron dendrites. Likewise, it will be arranged. So this was the photomicrograph picture of the neurons. So this is actually the cell body or cyton, and these are dendrites. And coming to the nervous tissue, so the nervous tissue, actually there is no physical contact between neuron to neuron. So usually the chemicals inside the neuron will pass through the other neuron. We call that chemical passaging between the neurons, and the connection between the neurons as synapse. Synapse is the point where the two neurons will meet, one dendrite and the other neuron axon terminal. That meeting place of two things, we call it as synapse. And the gap, we call it as synaptic cleft. So where the electrical impulse actually cannot cross. So that's why the chemical from one neuron will pass into the another neuron. So that chemical, we call it as neurotransmitter. And the neuroglial cells, these are the supporting cells. For example, we have seen the myelin sheath. So the myelin sheath is actually the supporting cells are the neuroglial cells, which actually acts as an insulator. Assume that axon as the copper wire, and the neuroglial cells, the myelination, as the plastic insulation around the copper wire. Likewise, the neurons will be arranged. And the neuroglial cells cannot conduct the electrical impulses. And coming to the central nervous system, which is the combination of brain and spinal cord, it receives the impulses from all over the body and process the information and respond according to that. So the bundles of the nerve fibers interconnecting, we call it as tracts. So in the central nervous system, which is in the brain and spinal cord, we have two types of matter. One is gray matter and other one is white matter. So why it is gray in color is because there we have only the dendrites and cell bodies. White matter is where we have the myelinated axons. Actually, the myelin is actually fat covering. So because of the fat covering, it looks white in color. And so the brain, coming to the brain, which is the one of the largest organ in the entire body. So one of the largest organ. So we have many largest organs like liver, skin, and brain is also one of the largest organ. It coordinates the most body activities. And it actually the center for thoughts, memory, judgment, and emotions. So this is the part of brain. So in this brain, I'll tell you the parts. So this part we call it as cerebrum. This is cerebrum. And this is cerebellum. So we have cerebrum, cerebellum. And this is diencephalon. This part we call it as diencephalon. And this is brainstem. Okay. Cerebrum, cerebellum, diencephalon, and brainstem. So this is cerebrum. In the diencephalon, we have two parts, thalamus and hypothalamus. This thalamus and hypothalamus together will form diencephalon. And in the brainstem, we have midbrain, pons, medulla oblongata. So midbrain, pons, medulla oblongata. All together, we call it as the brainstem. And coming to the cerebrum, which is the largest section and the upper portion. So just a moment. Hello. Okay. So coming to the cerebrum, which is the largest portion, it actually maintains the cognitive abilities like thinking, reasoning, problem solving, judgment, memory, all those higher intellectual things are being located in the cerebrum only. And in the cerebrum, the outer layer, I'll show you the picture. So in the cerebrum, this part we call it as this outer layer, we call it as cortex, this cerebral cortex. You are seeing the cerebral cortex only. If you cut this part, then inside was different. So this was cerebral cortex, and this foldings have a name also. So this depressions, we call it as sulci, and this elevations, we call it as gyri. So sulci and gyri. And coming to the lobes of cerebrum, so we have the four lobes. So we have two halves of the brain. So we call it as cerebral hemispheres. So like this, this is one half. Like this half is there on the right side and left side. So we have two cerebral hemispheres. And coming to the lobes. So in this picture, you can see. So this lobe, we call it as frontal lobe. And this lobe, we call it as parietal lobe. And this lobe, we call it as occipital lobe. And this lobe, we call it as temporal lobe. So frontal lobe, parietal lobe, occipital lobe, and temporal lobe. And this we call it as central fissure. So frontal, parietal, occipital, and temporal. So we have the four lobes of the cerebrum. And you can see in this picture, this depressions we call it as sulci, and this elevations we call it as gyri. For each and every lobe, we have a function. So this frontal lobe is for personality, speech, and movement. And this parietal lobe is for the language area, sensation. Okay. And this temporal lobe is for hearing and smell. And this occipital lobe is for vision. And this part we call it as cerebellum. So this we call for balance and coordination. And this is the brainstem. Midbrain was inside the brain. Pons, medulla oblongata. Medulla oblongata will continue as spinal cord. So diencephalon. So diencephalon consists of two parts, thalamus and hypothalamus. So thalamus is actually the sensations which will be there for eyes, ear. So the entire sensations will go and wait in the thalamus only. So thalamus is like a station, sensory relay station we call it as. From there only it will go to their respective areas. Hypothalamus. Hypothalamus will actually control the temperature, appetite, sleep, sexual desire, and emotion. So, and hypothalamus actually controls the autonomic nervous system. So, autonomic nervous system means automatic nervous system in our body. So we cannot control that. So cerebellum, which is the second largest portion of the brain, and it is mainly for controlling the coordinating and controlling the balance and equilibrium. It is present on the back side of the brain. And also it will be refining the muscular movements, means smoothening the muscular movements. And the brain stem. So we have the midbrain, pons, medulla oblongata. So midbrain acts as a connection between the brain and spinal cord. Pons means bridge. That will be connection between the cerebellum and the brain. Medulla oblongata is the lower part of the brain. It continues as spinal cord. And brain ventricles. So brain ventricles means inside the brain we have the spaces. So that spaces we call it as ventricles. So that contains the CSF, cerebrospinal fluid. So that is actually watery clear fluid, and it provides the shock protection for CNS. And the location will be, it will be present inside the cerebral hemispheres. One is in the thalamus and one is in the front of cerebellum. So totally we have four ventricles, four spaces. And coming to the spinal cord, the continuation of the medulla oblongata is called the spinal cord. So in the spinal cord will be inside this vertebral column. Okay, so inside this spinal cavity or the vertebral canal, we have the spinal cord. So from here to here, we have the spinal cord. In the spinal cord, we have the four sections, cervical, thoracic, lumbar, and sacral. And the lower part, we call it as coccygeal. Cervical means neck region, thoracic means upper back, lumbar, lower back, sacral, and coccygeal, tail region. So these are the five sections of the spinal cord. And in the spinal cord, if the fluid is, if the neurons are going from brain to towards the body, we call it as descending tracts. If the neurons are going from the sensory receptors towards the brain, we call it as ascending tracts. Ascending tracts will carry the information towards the brain. Descending tracts will carry the information away from the brain. And meninges. Coming to the meninges, so the membranes which are covering the brain, we call it as meninges. So you can see here, we have three layers. So dura mater, arachnoid matter, and pia matter. Okay, dura matter, arachnoid matter, and pia matter. So these three layers are, we call it as meninges of the brain. So this is the, this is the skin, and this is the bone of the skull, and this is epidural space, means the space present above the dura mater. And here we have the dura mater. This space we call it as subdural space, hence the space present below the dura mater. And this is arachnoid matter. And the space below the arachnoid matter we call it as subdural, subarachnoid space. And this is pia matter. And this part we call it as cerebral cortex. This is sulci and this is gyri. So dura mater was actually very tough, and it is the outermost layer. And the subdural space means the space present below the dura mater. And arachnoid matter. So the name arachnoid means it looks like a spider web. So this is actually not like very delicate like pia mater. It looks like a spider web. Below the space below the arachnoid matter, we call it as subarachnoid space. In this space only we have a fluid. That fluid we call it as cerebrospinal fluid. And pia mater. Pia mater was actually very soft. It will be directly attaches to the brain. And coming to the peripheral nervous system, we have the cranial nerves and spinal nerves. Totally we have 12 pairs of cranial nerves and 31 pairs of spinal nerves. So 12 pairs means right side 12 pair. So right side 12 nerves, left side 12 nerves. Likewise, right side 31 nerves and left side 31 nerves. Cranial nerves will be coming from the brain. Spinal nerves will be coming from the spinal cord. So one pair in the each side. So what is a nerve actually? Nerve means the cell which is electrically excitable. So which carries the messages from the receptors towards the brain and from the brain towards the receptors, towards the body. Nerve root. So the point where the nerve will come out of the CNS, we call it as nerve root. So, and coming to the cranial nerves, totally we have 12 pairs of cranial nerves. So I'll tell you the name. So how the cranial nerves we have to remind is, you have to know the Roman letters, Roman numbers. Always the cranial nerves will be having, have been denoted with the Roman numbers. So first cranial nerve, second cranial nerve, third cranial nerve, fourth cranial nerve, fifth cranial nerve. Likewise, we have 12 cranial nerves. For 12 cranial nerves, we have 12 names. Okay. So the first cranial nerve is olfactory. Olfactory means which is senses the smell. Olfaction means smell. And the second cranial nerve is optic, which is optic means sight, sense of sight. And the third cranial nerve, this is actually three. It was a typing mistake. It was given as two. Oculomotor, just remind, oculomotor, trochlear, and abducens. These three cranial nerves are for eyeball. So for movement of the eyeball only. So oculomotor, trochlear, and abducens. And next, fifth cranial nerve. Fifth cranial nerve, we call it as trigeminal. That is for facial sensation and controls the muscles of chewing. So our chewing muscles are controlled by trigeminal. And next, seventh cranial nerve is facial, which controls the facial muscles for expression, salivation, and for taste also. So all the facial muscles are supplied by facial nerve. And also the anterior two-third of the tongue, taste is also supplied by facial. Vestibulocochlear. So yesterday we have seen that vestibular part and cochlear part. That nerve is eighth cranial nerve. So sense of equilibrium and hearing. And ninth cranial nerve is glossopharyngeal nerve. So that is actually the sensations from pharynx and posterior one-third of the tongue. Glosso means tongue. Pharynx means throat. Tenth cranial nerve is vagus. Main internal organs are supplied by vagus nerve only, like heart, lungs, digestive system, likewise. And 11th cranial nerve is spinal accessory, which controls the neck and shoulder muscles. And 12th cranial nerve is hypoglossal, which supplies to the neck, tongue muscles. So coming to the next, neurons. Neurons will actually will carry the information to the brain and from the brain, from the brain and spinal cord. So we have two types of neurons. One is afferent neuron and other one is efferent neuron. Afferent neuron, we also call it as sensory neurons. Sensory neurons will actually carry the information towards the central nervous system, from the sensory receptor to central nervous system. Efferent neurons, we also call it as motor neurons, which will actually carry the information from the central nervous system towards the organs, muscles, or glands. And again, the peripheral nervous system is divided into two types. One is autonomic nervous system and other one is somatic nervous system. First one is autonomic nervous system. Autonomic nervous system or automatic nervous system. This nervous system will be not under our control. So it will be controlled by our by its own. So we have two parts of the autonomic nervous system. One is sympathetic and other one is parasympathetic. All the internal organs are supplied by autonomic nervous system only. Sympathetic means, for example, in for us, we have two types of situations. One is exaggerated. For example, when we are very much happy, very much excited, or when we are very anger, very frightening, in very tense situations, our heart rate, blood pressure, respiratory rate, and our blood flow, everything will get increases, except the hunger. So we can't feel hungry. For example, 1 hour before the examination, you won't feel the hunger. Because of the sympathetic nervous system activity, everything will get increases. And next, parasympathetic nervous system, it actually counterbalances the sympathetic nervous system. So everything will slow down. Heart rate, blood pressure, and everything will get slowed down except the digestion. For example, this parasympathetic nervous system is like when you are in a very relaxed and soothing mode, you will feel more hunger than when you are very excited. And somatic nerves. Somatic nerves are under our control. We can able to control it. So it actually supplies to the skin and skeletal muscles. So the information carries to the sensory receptors is touch, temperature, pressure, and pain. It actually carries the motor commands to the skeletal muscles. Okay. So, hello. Yeah, hello. Hello. Hello, Rekha.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Would you able to hear me?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, fine. Could you able to understand this topic?
Yes, ma'am.
But I know it was quite a bigger topic and quite difficult topic also. But you go through the slides. Now itself I am sending it. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. If you have any doubts, just send me through. If you have any doubts, just put a screenshot and text me. Okay.